Hello, welcome to Liberica Bar, small talks about Java and OpenJDK in informal way. Today we are going to discuss the popular themes of the last week, their new release of JDK 15. And it's time to welcome the much awaited version, and we will discuss it with performance architecture of Bellsoft, Dmitry Chuyko. Hi, Dmitry, thank you for coming. So let's discuss the highlights introduced in JDK 15. What are the main features that we can find there?
Well, if I speak of features, there are two major features, two garbage collectors that are now considered production ready. They are both low latency garbage collectors that perfectly worked with enormously large heaps. There's a Shenandoah and ZGC, and they are supported on multiple platforms. So you have a great choice between those options, and they continue to evolve. They previously had interesting enhancements in previous releases, and they, I'm sure, we'll continue to get more enhancements in upcoming releases. And if we talk about security, the important topic is, of course, cryptography and related stuff. So in this release, a new algorithm has been added for digital signature, which is EdDSA. This is one more part of ongoing work by adding new, more secure stuff, and deprecating less secure stuff or making it non-default. In previous releases, TLS 1.3 has been added, more algorithms were introduced. So there's no yet TLS 1.3 support for this one, but probably it will appear in the nearest future.
And what about text blocks?
Yeah, text blocks is a cool language feature that I really do like. You can embed any foreign code or whatever, any text as a single block inside your regular Java classes with indentation and all that stuff. You can do templating using that embedded text. So there were nice, small, handy features. It is very convenient to use and to manage. So yeah, please just use that.
Just try it. Yeah,
yeah. That was one of the reasons to try a preview a mode of JDKs of previous ones. Now it's just a release feature.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. And what else? Maybe we can tell about something about hidden classes, for example.
Yeah. So there's work going in the directions to have more clear view of how API is structured, how it's splitted, and what's allowed to do in runtime. So in runtime, you can generate bytecode to derive new classes. And previously, it has been done by using unsafe API. So you can derive a class and work with it as any other regular class, which may be not so great. Sometimes, because it may be messed up with different classes already existing in your runtime. So it is better clearly to say, okay, we don't work with those classes. We don't expect the regular Java code to call them, but we instead have a requirement to work with such classes using reflection. To discover their methods, making a call, so all the things, but just clearly state that this is kind of a dynamic thing. And in such case, older, unsafe, non-standard API is not necessary, so it will be deprecated and removed.
What about
deprecations?
Removing?
Yeah, and removals. We all like removals, less support, right? Yeah, so Solaris and Spark ports are now removed. So they still exist in OpenJDK source base, so yeah, nothing is removed from there, but they're not supported. There are no releases on that platforms.
So we can use just the old version?
Yes, you can use JDK 8 still or previous JDKs. So yeah, they're still supported. Some tiny API related to RMI, so with RMI activation, it's deprecated, but still all generic RMI stuff is there, so don't worry. Nashorn has been removed. It's been deprecated for a long time. No one really supports it, and we have alternatives, good alternatives for that. Maybe a buzz thing, removal of bias locking.
Why is it buzz thing?
Yeah, because people really considered either to enable or disable bias locking for performance for a long time. But really, if you think about that, if you still use vector and hash table in your programs, and they still are used in some single-threaded contexts, there's definitely something super wrong with your programs.
Okay, got it. Well, I think it's all about removing things. Maybe we should continue about the new features.
There's a second incubator for foreign memory access API. An API that allows you to work with memory also accessible by native libraries, or just to manage native memory as you wish to. And the API is now extended with some var handle part, which is really convenient. So yeah, it worth trying.
And what about thread local handshakes and about ARM and silicon?
This is kind of, as I said, many refinements happened during some ongoing work. And previously, thread local handshakes and optimization for more lightweight save points has been implemented for x86 and for ARM64. And it, in this release, it has been implemented for ARM32 by Bellsoft. Yeah, please use that if you use ARM32. You won't probably notice that, but it's there. One more ongoing change is a process of preparation for Project Loom.
It's going to change, or we can find it in JDK 15?
It's a separate project for now. It's not even like proposed to target, but a lot of things must be changed
for the next release.
For the next big change. And one of them is implementation of DatagramSocket API, which happened in this release. So you can just use that re-implemented API or be sure that things will work fine, then Project Loom will be integrated.
And what else interesting in JDK 15?
Yeah, one small but cool feature is that you can now get your heap dumps in gzipped format, which allows you to survive the heap dump of a huge heap, of really huge heaps, and to save your disk space. It is really convenient than you need the heap dumps of large heaps.
And connecting their big things, big release, and what should be right now, as far as I know, you're working with JEP 386 that are connected with Alpine Linux. Could we find something in JDK 15, or it's only the next release of 16 version?
Yeah, it's been proposed to target JDK 16. So we have good chances to be there in 16. And the JEP is about integration of Project Portola into JDK mainline, which will unify the codebase and ease the process of development for Alpine Linux support. And this allows to use smallest base Docker images, for example, in case then we provide JDKs for containers.
But the users right now can download containers and use them.
Yes, it's already supported, but the final integration is to make the code more clean, to fix potential problems, and to unify how different companies solve that problem.
So I think we could discuss Jeb a little bit more in details, but let's do it in the next episode. Yes. I think it's quite an interesting theme.
Yeah. It's worth it.
Well, and what should be weight in 16 versions? Version.
Yeah, I already started the talk about containers. So a good thing for containers is to return unused memory, uncommitted, and return it to operating system. So the host can give it to another container on the same machine. So this now happens not just for Heap, but also for a metaspace. And the JEP is called Elastic Metaspace, and it's been targeted to JDK 16. And also, I expect more ports, not just Alpine Linux muscle, but also AR64 for Windows. Probably still not proposed to target or targeted, but discussed one is a port for macOS on Apple Silicon, which is really interesting. We are longer waiting for that new Macs coming.
Yeah, that's one of the favorite theme of our Twitter followers, discussing who is the next, who is the first Microsoft or Apple.
Yeah. Some things already happened for 16 that are good for development of JDK. First of all, of course, it is migration to GitHub and Git in general. So when I have cool Scara features, and really they are really used from the very beginning. So this is a positive experience. And also codebase of HotSpot has been cleaned up, and it's now ready for C++ 14 features, which will help to use standard approach, more standard approach for development of JDK.
Should we wait something extraordinary in 16 version?
As usual.
Yeah.
I don't know exactly what it will be, but for sure, yeah, some big features will be in 16.
Can you imagine what could it be?
I would wish it be Project Loom, but we'll see. As for features currently targeted, there's also Vector API, which we now have implementations for both Intel and ARM. So it will be interesting to see how it will be used in standard library or in third-party libraries for speed up of calculations on the hardware that supports vectors.
Yeah, that's quite interesting. Maybe something else?
I think that's probably most of it, yes.
So we will wait for the 6th version, but now everybody should remember that you should upgrade your 14 version to the 15 because of security and all vulnerability fixes, of course.
And it's better to use it in some automated way, for example, by using repositories that they provide for Liberica, for Linux, Yaman, apt. But there are also other options. So any one is good if you just get automated updates or you get notified. Then update is available. So it's important to start testing and integration of this new functionality.
Okay, so don't forget to upgrade. So I think that's all that we would like to discuss today. Well, thank you to Dmitry. I will wait for our another meeting and talking about JEP. Subscribe on our YouTube channel and read news in our newsletter. We will prepare something interesting for you soon. Thank you and bye.